put me back together. Great desires will satisfy hearing you, Lord. Oh, there's nothing better than you.
There's nothing better than you.
Oh, there's nothing. Nothing is better than you. Oh, I know it's true. Come on, let's worship the Lord, somebody. Afraid to show you my weakness, my failure, my fault. Lord, you've seen them all, and you still call me friend. 'Cause the God of the mountain, come on, somebody, worship the Lord. God in the valley.
And grace won't find me again.
Oh, there's nothing better than you. Better than you. Oh, there's nothing. I have to share this, so hold on. You know, if all of you will share and invite and tag and subscribe, maybe I won't have to do this. So please forgive me. God bless you. Welcome. So give me a few minutes here.
Nothing is better than you.
Oh, I know it's true. Welcome, you too, welcome. He turned bones into army, Ezekiel 37. He turned seas into highway. He split the Red Sea. It's time for the Atlantic Ocean to be split. Who's going to do it? I am. Hey. He turned graves into garden. He turned bones to army. Are you listening to the chorus of that song? He turned what? Graves into garden. He turns sea into highway. That's when he split the Red Sea. He turned bones into army. Ezekiel 37, when he spoke to this valley of dry bone, come forth. And the vast mighty army rose up. It's time. That's the God you serve. You better recognize that. Hello, somebody. Who's ready? Are you ready for war? Is there any warriors in the house on Facebook? Can you share this for me real quick on all your platforms? Both Facebook and YouTube. Quick. I want a full house up in here. We got to pray. Hello? I say I want a full house up in here. You know what makes me mad? Sometimes I don't come on live. I'm going to tell you the truth. No, I wait till we get a full house and I'll tell you the truth. Let's worship. Yes, Lord.
And you came along and put me back together. And every desire is now satisfied.
I'm gonna worship.
Show you my weakness, my failures, my faults. Lord, you sing them all, and you still call me friend. Cause the God of the mountain is the God of the valley. Mercy and grace won't find me again. Oh, there's nothing better than you.
There's nothing, Lord. Oh, there's nothing.
Nothing is better than you. I know. There's no one or nothing is better than the Lord. Are dancing.
You give
beauty for ashes.
You
turn shame into glory.
The only one who cares.
The only one.
You
turn grace into body.
Bones into
army. He split the Red Sea in half. Come on.
Only one who can.
Oh, I know. Yes, Lord. Hold on. You're the only one who can. Facebook, YouTube, you ready? I'm going to open up in prayers, and we're going to shake this place up in her. There's a sister that put the, can you tell me how you pray for 5 hours straight? Also, can you give any tips on fasting and prayer? Okay, if Sister Karen that put that comment or that question, if you're still around, let me know so I can answer your question. So, bless you. I know you asked that question in one of my live videos. I told you to email me. But my email information, if you just look on YouTube, on the bottom of the screen, you'll see some red and white letters going across the screen. Those are all my contact information. Thank you. Let me open up in prayer so we can shake this place. Facebook, did you share this? Did you share this and invite anyone and tag? Do quick. YouTube, you know you have to share, right? Thank you very much. Let me open up in prayer. Father, thank you, Lord, for the privilege and the honor to wake us up. Thank you that we have privilege and we have the honor to come and freely use our liberty and freedom to worship you, to serve you in spirit and in truth, in the beauties of holiness. We don't know how long we have such freedom and liberty because we live in a Babylonian culture, and it seems like wickedness and darkness is increasing. Hell is enlarging its appetite, and censorship is at an all-time high. But Lord, we know you are in control. Spirit of God, you are welcome to get a hold of this meeting and wreck it. You know how you fell in the upper room and you wrecked the disciples' lives. They were never the same. Lord, we invite you once more. Let your spirit fall and wreck this meeting. Wreck our lives that we are never the same. In the name of Jesus, speak to us and speak through us. Have your way in our midst. Lord, let there be no distraction, disruption, interruption, or interference from any forces or powers of darkness. For this meeting, Lord, is for your ears and your ears only, and that of your holy angels. Welcome the armies of God, the hosts of heavens, the great cloud of witnesses, the 24 elders, the 7 spirits of God, the 4 living creatures, all of heaven, weapons, forces, armies, resources. You are welcome to join us on the battlefield in the name of Jesus. Hebrews 12:22 says, you have come to Mount Zion, the heavenly Jerusalem, the city of the living God. In our midst are innumerable, countless upon thousands of angels in joyful procession. You have come to the church of the firstborn, whose names are registered in heaven, to the spirits of the just men made perfect, to God the judge of all, to Jesus the mediator, the go-between of the new covenant, to his sprinkled blood that speaks better things for us than the blood of Abel. Welcome to Mount Zion, the holy mountain of God, where you encounter God and his holy angels and his holy fiery burn, his holy fiery remnants. Welcome to the mountain in Jesus' name. I salute you. Are you ready? Welcome to the Warriors Prayer Boot Camp. I'm your prayer drill sergeant, Dagnet, and I greet you with a salute. I salute you, sir. I salute you, ma'am. This is the boot camp where wimps becomes warriors, chickens become eagles, kitty cat becomes lion or lioness. You come to the boot camp, beloved, to learn how to utilize the divine authority placed upon your lips and how to utilize the divine authority placed upon your lips and how to develop some spiritual backbone. So you're not born again 1 year, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, and you are still a wimp. You're a whiner, murmurer, complainer. You're still drinking milk. You need someone to exchange your pampers. You need a pacifier, and you're offended, and this person will offend me, and I got church hurt, and the pastor didn't recognize me, and I used to sing in the choir, and they told me to sit down. All kinds of offense. This in the place for it, and this in the time and season upon the earth for it. It's time for us to grow up, show up, or shut up. Can I get an amen? Welcome to the boot camp. This is where your boot hits the ground, both physically and spiritually, doing warfare for the souls of nations. Bring nations and kingdoms and people group into the kingdom. This is where we do that. We wage war for the souls of nations. We wage war on behalf of heaven's agenda to impose it on this earth. And whoever come and stand against us, the guys going to bulldoze them. They got to go. Are you with me? You remember? We have a testimony. Sister Tillman, welcome. I salute you. Welcome, beloved. Thank you, beloved. Facebook, YouTube, ready? We have a testimony, remember? You don't remember? You must go watch yesterday morning video. Today is what? I'm going to say the date. Today is Tuesday, October 6th, 2020. Monday, October 5th, 2020, during our live prayer video session. And that's between 7 a.m. to 9, 10 a.m. Eastern Standard USA time. But when I get up, I'm going to get that clip. I'm going to add my 2 cents, and I'm going to upload that clip. But we prayed yesterday for President Trump. And one of the prayers I remember clearly, you may not remember because I prayed a lot of prayer, but one of the prayers that I prayed, that I want him back, healed, ready, and back into the White House before Friday this week. We said that yesterday morning. Yesterday evening, he was in the White House. Can I get an amen? You see how quick our prayer will answer? I said, talk to me, somebody. It got me fired up. Did you not notice? You see, when we pray, you don't pay attention. I shouldn't even be the one saying that. You should be telling me we prayed that yesterday. Because you weren't paying attention. Hello? Or are you getting F in this class today? Yes. Talk to me, somebody. But I still love you. Come back. Maybe tomorrow you get an A. Is there anybody up in the house? Talk to me, Jody. Talk to me. You don't believe me? I'll go find a video from yesterday. I will record just that clip. That 5 minute clip that we pray and I said those words. I will re-record it and put it and upload it there. Because I got to add my 2 cents to it. You know I always... Thank you very much. I know specifically, I pray. I led all of us into prayer. That we want him healed, delivered clean, and set free and back into the White House before Friday this week. We pray that Monday morning. Monday evening, he was back into the White House. That ought to make you all excited. That ought to get you fired up and stirred up. That ought to build up your confidence that you serve a prayer answering God, and we're in a season of sowing and reaping where things are accelerating. That you can sow a seed of prayer, whether of good or evil, you will reap it. Hello? So whatever you don't want to reap in your own life, please, don't sow in somebody else's life. That's why all those little demons, I call them demons manifest in the flesh. They were all over Twitter and social media. You see the heart of some of the Democrats. They are so vile. They are so diabolical. They are so evil and so wicked. They are wishing death. They were wishing death on him. But now that they're disappointed, but they will eat the fruits of their own lips. It is in the scripture. A man must reap what he sowed. A man will eat the fruits of his lips. There's 3 or 4 different scriptures that says that. A man will eat the fruits of his own lips. It's not just for Christians. It's for anyone. It didn't say Christians will eat the fruits of their own lips. It said a man will eat the fruits of his own lips. It didn't say only Christians. So whether you're Christian, whether you're Muslim, whether you're a witch, whether you're atheist, all of those that were wishing and issuing death threats, they're going to eat the fruits of their own lips. Simple. And my warning to you, or my suggestions, or however you want to take it up to you, be mindful and careful what you say about others. Whatever you don't want manifested in your own life, please don't speak over somebody else's life, because you're going to reap it as well. Mm-hmm. Me, when I wake up in the morning, that's my decree. I pray right there. I say, Father, anybody who wishes blessings, who issues blessings and good thoughts towards me and good prayers for me and towards me, Father, multiply back into their lives sevenfold as you also bless me. But anybody who also issues curses, chanting, divination, gossiping, lying, backbiting, character assassination, anyone who spread anything negative and evil about me, Father, also grant them the privilege to eat the fruits of their own lips sevenfold. That's what I pray when I wake up. So listen, I'm just saying, you don't know what people pray when they wake up in the morning, so watch your mouth. That's what I got to say. That's my decree in the morning. Anybody who issues blessings, protection, love, send me wonderful prayers and love and blessings, provision, protection, healing, whatever you send over my life, I say, Lord, may the Lord bless you, and he return it back to you sevenfold. You curse me, you will also receive it sevenfold. So you choose now. You choose this day what you want, curses or blessings. Simple as that. All of us are not ordinary Christians. Some of us know our right and our authority, and we utilize every morning. Amen, somebody. I don't know what happened to YouTube. YouTube, is this working? I see the... Somebody on YouTube, talk to me. Let me know if this is working or not. I don't want us to have any problem here. Facebook looks like it's working good, I think. Is there anybody on Facebook? Can you talk to me real quick? I see we have a few numbers in Facebook, but I don't see any comments. So I hope... YouTube, is this working? Yes, no? It's working? Thank you very much. Okay. So we prayed yesterday that we want him back into the White House before Friday this week. We pray Monday morning. Monday evening, he was back. I gotta turn this fan off. It's low. Hold on. Alright. Okay. I think that's good enough. We ready, y'all? Facebook, we ready? YouTube, we ready? Yes, okay, Sister Thelma said it's working on YouTube. Thank you. All right, I wanted to make sure. Facebook is working? Thank you. So we're going to continue to pray. Now we have prayed that the Lord should bring him back into the White House before Friday. We pray Monday morning, Monday evening, our prayer is answered. Yes. Now we're going to continue to pray. My next prayer point, I want this corona out. I want it dealt with now and out. I want it to be a thing of the past. I don't want to hear his name mentioned. I don't want it to be used as a tool and a weapon to spread fear, propaganda, hatred. I want it out of this nation. I want it out of Africa. Whatever nation you're connecting from, you better pray that prayer for your nation. I want it. I'm done. I want this thing called Corona, COVID, whatever name you call. And all of those who behind it, who brought it, they and the Corona, they have to go. Are you with me? I say I want this thing called Corona, COVID, whatever name it called itself. Because they are allegedly plotting for a second wave. Because Bill Gates kept saying that from the beginning. Well, there's a second wave coming. No, it ain't. You going. Before your second wave comes, you're going to be out of here. All of you who are responsible for pushing this evil, diabolical, demonic agenda upon humanity and almost literally wrecking the economies of nations. It is wicked and it's evil. You got to go, and you're going to pay before you go. You know yourselves. I call you principalities in the flesh. Principalities manifesting in the flesh. We are no longer dealing with small, low-level devils. You know what I'm saying? We are no longer battling and dealing with small demons. No, we are now contending with principalities. There's someone that called himself Bill Gates. Dr. Fraudsy. I call him Fraudsy. I think that was his real name. He changed it to Fauci. But it's fraud. It's just a letter missing out of there. Put it there. Don't call him Dr. Fauci no more. Poor fraud. Everybody from now, you must post hashtag Dr. Fraudsy. Dagnet said it. If I ever get to meet him, I'm going to call him. I'll say, nice to meet you, sir. Shake your hand. Dr. Fraudsy. If you correct me, I say, you need to correct your, you need to change the spelling of your name. You got it wrong. Mm-hmm. Hello, we got Dr. Fraud C. Has lived up to his name. He's a big fraud. He gonna be exposed. He gotta go. Hello, somebody. Are you with me, Facebook? Are you with me, YouTube? I'm vexed. I'm vexed in my spirit. I'm vexed and I'm angry. But the Bible called it holy righteous indignation. I have to explain myself. Because when you live stream, people come in and out, they hear that word is, oh, she says she's Christian, she's angry. When the Bible says you should anger, sin not. So I have to always explain myself. Some of you are familiar with what I mean. But because people pop in and out, I must always explain myself. Because some religious carnal baby Christian will just take that word and go wrong with it. That's how they will spread lies. You know that. Well, I keep warning them. We are in a season of sowing and reaping. Things are accelerating. Any kind of lies, propaganda, hatred, anything you spread on anybody's name that is spread like wildfire on social media, you will reap it instantaneously 7 times. So I'm not even worried about whether people turn against me. They don't turn against me. They spread stuff. I'm not even worried no more. They will. Each man will reap it. Each man will reap their own 7 times. You don't even. The season within my beloved, you don't even have to pray against your enemies. Just be focused on what God has called you to do. Remember Moses? Remember Moses? Moses was busy doing his father's business, whereas his sister Miriam and his brother was behind his back gossiping and talking bad about him, correct? Moses had no clue. He was clueless because he was not focused on my enemies. My enemies, my this, they, you know. Many Africans will focus on enemies. Don't focus on enemies. Just be focused about your father's business. It was God who took offense. Can I get an amen? I said, because Moses was a friend of God. A man who walked with God and talked to God face to face as a man talks to his friend. Moses was a friend of God, a lover of God, a prophet, a mouthpiece of God. And he was busy doing God's business. And how dare you bunch of gossipers, his own brother and sister, gossiping about him. God took offense. It wasn't Moses that took offense and went and complained to God and said God judged them. It wasn't. You see the difference between Moses, Old Testament Christians, and today, so-called New Testament Christians that are always praying for the enemies to die. You see the difference? Moses was busy and focused about his father's business. And God heard them gossiping and talking bad about his friend, Moses. And God was the one who took offense and dealt with them. It wasn't Moses who laid Miriam's complaint and said, God, you see what she's doing? Judge her. Mm-mm. It was God who took offense and judged her. And then he went and told, after he finished dealing with her, then he went and told Moses. Then Moses had to intercede. Plead for mercy on her behalf. Just be busy and focus about your father's business. Let them talk, gossip, spread, assassinate your character. Let them carry on. They're going to cross God and get on the wrong side of God. And he will judge them. And then he will come and tell you that you have to intercede on their behalf. Are you with me? Just be focused about your father's business. Let them talk. That's the devil's job anyway, is to go to and fro looking for who he can devour. Just make sure you are not a weak link. Make sure you are not amongst the weakest link in any group or organization so he doesn't use you to tear down a friend of God so God don't have to judge you, so his anger don't come against you. Make sure you guard your heart and guard your eyes. Guard your heart and your eyes and your salvation in this season with death, with fear, and with trembling. Guard it. So the enemy does not penetrate any kind of thoughts or seed or arrows or sparrows in your heart against anyone for whatever reason. Don't. So you don't find yourself in the wrong side of God. Miriam did. See what happened to her? Hello? So you got to focus on your enemies, worried about what they're doing, mind what they're saying. Don't mind them. Leave them alone. Focus on your father's business. Let them keep talking. They will say something about you that will offend God and God will deal with them. Miriam spoke against Moses. God got offended. He dealt with her. Moses had no clue. Focus on your father's business. Let them keep talking. Let them keep spreading lies. Let them try to assassinate your character, poison people's mind against you. Let them carry on. It is not my job to be offended. My job is to be focused on doing my father's business. He's going to be the one who's going to get offense. And then they find themselves in the wrong side of God. Some heads going to roll. I'm just saying. Hello, somebody. Anyway, I don't know how I got into this subject of Moses, but praise the Lord. Are you with me? Oh, Sister Bimbo, welcome. I salute you. Facebook, are you with me? YouTube, did you share this? Did you share this and invite a few people? We ready to pray? Sister Bimbo, you are late, but I will have to repeat this because I want you to hear this. She's on Facebook. I want to repeat this because I want you to hear this. I don't know if you prayed with us yesterday morning, but if you didn't, you have to watch the video. But we prayed yesterday morning. One of the prayers that I led us to pray yesterday morning was that President Trump, thank you for sharing, that we want President Trump well and healthy and out of that hospital back into the White House before Friday. We prayed that prayer yesterday morning. Monday, yesterday evening, he was out. It's a prayer answering God. The next prayer we're going to pray, we want Corona out. We want Corona out of America, out of Africa. Wherever you are, you better pray. We're going to pray. I'm tired and I've had enough of this Corona nonsense and madness. It have silenced the world. It have terrorized the world. It have literally shut down the world, quarantined humanity, caused fear and propaganda. People even hating people. You walk down the street, if you don't wear masks, people look at you like something's wrong with you. I mean, now they're standing at the door. Yesterday, there's a Target down the street from me. Usually, I just walk in. I don't wear my mask today. Yesterday, I went there. They're standing at the door. You have to wear mask. That's the only time I put it on, so I had to put it on. Well, as soon as I got in the store, I took it off. I'm serious. Yes, he said, you got your mask. I look in my bag. I said, well, I don't think I have any. Do you have one? He gave me a brand new one. I put it on. As soon as I passed in, I yanked that thing up right off. I can't breathe. Thank you very much. Hello. I'm here to breathe fresh air, not carbon dioxide. Hello. My body was not designed to breathe in carbon dioxide. No, man. No, sir. I ain't going to inhale my own breath. Hello. Last time I checked, I don't think my breath was stink. Thank you very much. Hello. But anyway, So because of the president, now they want to make it mandatory that everybody must wear masks. That's the point. I don't even believe they say, oh, he out of the woods, or he's not out of the woods yet. He was never in the woods to begin with. Hello. I say all of this thing was staged, was planned, it's propaganda, because if you pay attention during the time of the debate, he was making a mockery of Joe Biden wearing this big old face mask. So isn't it so, don't you find it so odd or curious to think, okay, he has always made a mockery of Joe Biden after the debate, out of the something that he allegedly supposedly have Corona. No, it's part of the fear mongering, pushing agenda to come and say, you see, we told you this thing is very serious. Even President Trump, now the whole world's watching. You see the thing? We told you how serious this is. The leader of the free world, the most powerful nation. Look, you see, even if President Trump can get it, what about you? Then all the panicking robots, the people who have been so brainwashed, now they all fear. Oh, yes. Oh, I fear. You don't bring it. I don't. Shut up the mainstream media, man. They are the biggest propaganda machine in the Western world, and they need to be shut down. It's time we're going to go target them. They are my next target, too, also. So they're pushing that. But guess what? He was never in the woods. And I'm praying that, Father, in the name of Jesus, we want this Corona hoax exposed. We want those responsible to be brought to trial. A case against humanity. They must be tried and found guilty and found wanting. I say we want this Corona hoax pulled back the veil. We want the Corona hoax brought to light. And the Corona hoax, the pandemic, we want it hoax, we want it brought to light. That means exposed. All of those responsible behind it, we want them exposed, brought to light. We want them to go to court and they must be found guilty. Charge them with a crime against humanity. Charge them, they must be found guilty. And all the money they have earned in the fiasco, it must be given back to humanity. Because they have destroyed people's lives, businesses, ministries, marriages, schools. People commit suicide, drug addiction, marriage have been destroyed. Husband can't work. Their house, they lose their house. They lose their car. They lose their apartment. People are getting to be homeless. It's not fair. It is no fault of your own, then, but you have to suffer for it. No, it must end. So we're going to pray. Are you ready? You see, this one makes me a little bit upset. I call for a prayer meeting. How many people will be here with me on Facebook and YouTube? But when the people on the other side, when they call for their prayer meeting, it's called a rioting. Thousands shows up. Then we're going to be the same person complaining. Oh, they burn down the city, they're looting. If enough of you are praying, those demons won't possess them to do that nonsense. Are you with me? If enough of you were praying, those demons will not be possessing those people to go burn your city down. But I say, let's pray where you are now. This is our protest. We are protesting spiritually. When they do that protest, but if, because there's not enough Christian protesting on their faces, on their knees, that's how come your city are being burned down. If enough of us are sending out angels to arrest those demons, those people won't be possessed by demons to go to tear down cities. They won't. Hello, somebody. Or maybe you two are just messing with them. What do you call it? The algorithm. Mm-hmm. They do that too. People who subscribe to my channel, they say sometimes they be searching, they can't even find me. What's up with that? Don't you find that odd? Mm-hmm. Because usually if you subscribe to somebody's channel, you should be able to find them easily. They can't even find me. They type my name, they still can't find me. Yes. They're messing with the wrong person. Because I'm angry now. I'm telling you, I'm not playing games. No more. Mm-hmm. Holy righteous anger, I'm talking about. Holy righteous indignation. The Bible called it holy righteous anger. It's the same holy righteous anger that Jesus had when he entered the temple and he flogged them and he flipped the table. I say it's time for some flipping tables prayers. It's time for some head rolling prayer like Daniel and Goliath. David and Goliath. Are you ready to pray? You're going to open your mouth and you're going to pray. I want you to be vexed in your spirit and angry. That these people for the past 4 to 6 months, they have literally changed the way you live. They have altered the way you live, the way you do business, the way you go to work, the way you go to school, the way you minister, the way you worship your God. They have changed everything. Now everything is done remotely, isn't it? They have literally, that's how much control and power a handful of people have. That in 4 to 6 short months, they shut the world down. They literally change how we live. They have dictated to you. They have made a dictator demanded how you should live, period. You go outside, you go shopping, you must wear masks. Wash your hand 3, 4, 5 times a day. Use alcohol sanitizer or something. I don't do any of those things, and I'm not getting nothing. I have my immune boost tea that I drink 2-3 cups a day. I'm good. I also sell it. Thank you very much. Yes, and I'm good. I ain't catching it. It is not catching me, period. Are you guys with me, beloved? For 4 to 6 months, these people have literally altered how you live. And you are still okay. I'm not okay anymore. Maybe I was taking it easy with them. I'm done. We prayed yesterday morning for our president to be set free into the White House. In the evening, our prayer was answered. And you see how quick that is. I want to encourage you and stir you up. We're about to go to some warfare. We want to pray that those behind this corona hoax, I call it corona hoax or corona pandemic, we're going to pray. Everyone behind it, they must, number one, be exposed. Number two, they must be found guilty and charged with a crime against humanity. They must be made to pay financially and pay with everything else they got. That means their name, their platform, their businesses, their empire, their kingdom. Everything must be stripped away from them. Bring them down to nothing. Let them know what it feels like. What they have done to other people. They have brought some people down to nothing. That people have lost their job, their home, their cars, their businesses. You have taken a responsible man and made him a nobody. They will reap it. They will all become nobodies overnight. Before we pray, we're going to pray. We're going to plead the blood of Jesus. Let me find that video. You know what I'm talking about, right? It's my 5-minute blood of Jesus prayer, if I can find it. I need to start putting it on the playlist or something. Let me see. Because when I try to look for it, it's difficult to find. You turn roses to garden. You're the only one who cares. All right. I just have to pray off my memory then. I know most of you pretty much. It's only 5 minutes, but I think I know it off heart. So YouTube, Facebook, you're going to open your mouth. First, all of us, you're going to open your mouth. I will lead you into prayer, but you open your own mouth and pray. You can pray what I'm saying, or you can use your own words. It's okay. We're going to first all confess and repent of our sins individually and corporately as the church. Then we'll pray the blood of Jesus, don't go to deal with principalities. Why do I do that in order? Because when you begin to deal with principalities and devil, they will come. But when they come, so they can find nothing in you. Because Jesus said, I've given you all power to tread upon all serpents and scorpions. But he also said, those serpents and scorpions came to me, they found nothing in me. You want to make sure that those serpents and scorpions and principalities, that when they come to you, they must find nothing in you. No anger, no bitterness, no pride, lust of the eyes, lust of the flesh, the pride of life, arrogance, backbiting, murmuring, gossiping, contentiousness, malice. What else? You name it. Little foxes, whatever, disobedient, whatever. You're going to ask the Lord to get it out of you now. Then we'll plead the blood of Jesus. Then it's time to take some heads. You ready? Hashtag. I want you to put hashtag on the screen. Pick one of these three hashtags. You can put hashtag, let's shake this place. Hashtag, bring it on. Hashtag, let's rumble. Pick one, pop it on the screen, let's do that. I'm waiting. Come on, somebody. Come on, talk to me. Are you ready, Jaddy? Talk to me. Where is the thing here? Oop, no, that's the wrong folder, though. I want to put this in my gospel folder. Where is it? Oh, it's already there. Okay, cool. Let me get to my gospel playlist. I'm coming, you guys. I'm just pulling up my gospel playlist so we can do some worship here. We're going to pray in the Holy Ghost right now. We're going to cleanse. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Facebook, you ready?
This time of year, I'm always looking for the best way to
find. Are you guys ready to shake this place? Ed said, hashtag Trump 2020. Oh, thank you, Ed, but you got to follow the instruction. We didn't say that. I said put a hashtag. Please follow the instruction. Thank you very much. We pray for Trump. Don't worry about that. But follow the instruction. The instruction said, are you ready to rumble? So you don't come here and run the show. Thank you very much. Well, you're welcome, Ed. God bless you. Who's ready to shake this place? Hashtag let's rumble. Hashtag let's bring it on. Hashtag let's shake this place. Pick one, put on the screen. We're about to pray. We're taking down some heads today. I said there's some Goliath. You know, while I'm waiting for your hashtag, let me say something else. As I was showering yesterday morning, I was thinking. I said, you know, during the days of Elijah, Elijah only had one Jezebel to contend with. I said, but Father, in our days, we have several different Jezebels. Oprah Winfrey, Hillary Clinton, Pelosi, and I'm sure Ruth Bader Ginsburg, but other Jezebel she has been dealt with. Thank you very much. Anyway, are you with me? Well, I'm sure there's some other, so many little, small little Jezebel hiding somewhere. The Satanists and the witches and all those LGBT and, you know what I'm saying? I said, so during the days of Elijah, he had just one Jezebel. We have so many Jezebels to contend with in this hour. During the days of David, he only had one Goliath. In our days, we have several different Goliaths to take their heads. The pharmaceutical industry, that's a Goliath. The Dr. Fraud C, that's what I call him, Fraud C. The Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. The CDC, the UN, the MSN mainstream fake news media. We have so many Goliaths here that has to roll. So we have a lot more Goliaths and more Jezebel to contend with in the hour. And we will contend with them until they either bow the head to God or those heads going to roll. That's my prayer. Simple. You're going to bow or your head's going to roll. Pick one. Turn from your wicked ways or burn. Simple, man. Ain't no time to be nice. Play nice. Let's go along to get along. It's over. It's time for war. Are you with me? Who's ready to shake this place? Thank you very much. Are we ready now? Thank you, Sister Bimbo. Thank you. Okay, you're going to open your mouth, you're going to pray, and you're going to confess and repent your own sins. You're going to repent. I already explained to you why. Open your mouth, everybody, and pray and say, Lord, search me. Search me now and make sure there's nothing of the enemy found in me. So when we begin to contend with those Jezebels, when they come to us, they find nothing in us. Because Jesus said, the enemy came to me, he found nothing in me. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, search me. If there be any root cause of darkness found in me, expose it to me, get it out. Strip away and take everything out of me that represents the unfruitful works of darkness, malice, pride, bitterness, unforgiveness, pity party, jealousy, hatred, contentiousness, racism, sexism, any ism, prejudice, anything that God does not like, that doesn't represent his light, his love, and his kingdom. I give him permission, Lord, drive it out of my soul. Pray like that for yourself. Pray in the spirit, everybody. Let's do this. Open your mouth and pray in Jesus' name. After that, we're going to pray the blood of Jesus. Then we'll go to take some Goliath's head. But open your mouth and pray right now. Repent and confess. Let's do this. Everybody, open your mouth and pray. Pray in the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. Hey, Rabako Hosa Ribaboto, yes, ye the Libiki Tila Kahasari. Wondo Robo Yokote, ye Kisari Bakahasate, Rabako Ho. Erika Sanderia Bakodo, yes, te ye Kira Katana, yisari Babote, ye Rebo Yokoho. Wondo Robo Yokoho, so te ye Kiheseri. Wondo Robo Yokoho, so te ye ki. La ki la kande rakona maya kahasare oboyi siti liya kahasere. O Spirit of God, when you begin to strip everything out of me that you find offensive, everything in me, every part of my nature, my attributes, my characteristic, anything about me and in me concerning me that represents darkness, expose it to me and drive it out. Put the axe to the root. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, strip away every filthy garment of anger and pride and bitterness. Cleanse me and purge me, refine me and purify, sanctify, make me a vessel, pure and holy for the master's use. So when the enemy comes to me, Lord, he finds nothing in me. Pray like that for yourself. Pray like that for yourself, everybody. Open your mouth and pray in Jesus' name. Hey, Rabo Karakahasari, Urabe Kasante, Rabakoho, One Ye Ribi Kataye, Sande Rababura Kahasari. O se te ye riba kahasari. Ora maye kataya kiti, purify my heart. Purify my motives, O God. Cleanse me. Creating me a pure heart. Pure motives. Pure desire. Pure intentions towards God and all men. Sanctify this vessel, O God. Open your mouth and pray for yourself like that. We want to go to war, so open your mouth and pray for yourself. Hey, Rababura kahasari. Osete ye de libi kiti la kahasate la riba kota be ra kahasati la bakoho sonde rebe ke heseri onoro bi kari la ye sande ra bakoho e ra bakoho sati ra bakaha o ra be kahasate riba koho osete rebe be riba bo ra kaha ona ya kahasati la bori ya kahasate o Lord, purify us. Everyone who's watching with me, everyone who's about to pray with me, oh God, through it, I'm asking you, Lord, to cover us and cover us with the blood of Jesus. May you sanctify and purify every one of us, all who's going to pray this prayer live or in a rebroadcast. May the Spirit of God begin to purge and cleanse us. May you begin to purify and sanctify us. Wash us, oh God, in the blood of the Lamb. Cleanse us, forgive us of all our sins. Father, in the name of Jesus, we repent of all our sins. Anything that represents sins, Father, we repent today. I plead the blood of Jesus over my sins and the sins of this nation. I say, Lord, forgive us and have mercy upon us. Purge us and sanctify. Purify and refine us, oh God. That when we stand before you and begin to pray, all you see is the blood of the Lamb. When the enemy comes to us, Lord, he finds nothing in us. Oh, Lord, in Jesus' name, cover us with your blood. Now let's use the blood. Father, in the name of Jesus, I plead your blood over the doorpost of my house, of my apartment, of my car, of my dog, my bank account, this ministry, all my gadgets and instruments I'm using to pray. Pray like that. Father, I plead your blood over everything concerning me. May the blood of, pray for yourself like that. Don't say amen. Pray for yourself like that. May the blood of Jesus be used as a weapon to shield and to fortify everything concerning me, oh God. I plead your blood over my life, over my ministry, over my businesses, over everything concerning me, over the doorpost of my heart. I plead the blood of Jesus, oh God, fortify, shield, guard, and protect me from all the flaming darts of the enemy. As you're about to lead us into warfare, that when the enemy comes, he finds nothing in us. Even if he tries to release his fiery darts, it bounces off and go back to him. Sevenfold, that his own weapon of destruction against us will be turned on his own head, in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. We have cleansed, purged, sanctify, purify ourselves. We have invited the blood of Jesus as a weapon, a shield to fortify and protect us. Now I'm ready for war. Who's ready with me? Now I'm fired up, and it's time for some war. What are we going to pray? You're going to open your mouth. Why is there nobody? Facebook, why is there place not full? We had a full house on Facebook yesterday. What's going on with you, Facebook? Thank you. YouTube, are we ready now? Now you're going to open your mouth. I don't want you to be multitasking. I don't want you to be texting. I want you to be focused. Many Christians have a casual approach to warfare. That's how come most of them become a casualty in warfare. You can't be praying this kind of prayer. You wander in your mind. That's why always when we're about to pray, no texting, long conversation. Because you cannot be praying and talking to God and then you texting. Because for you to text, you got to think about what you say, how to say it, and you put it down. Don't come in the presence and you want to talk to God, then you texting. No multitasking. It must cease right now in Jesus' name. And we're about to hit the target. Focus. The book of Acts said they gather together in one accord. With one mind, like passion, one spirit, and one voice. Even when the Bible said, the Tower of Babel, the people spoke with one language, and God said, and whatever they desire, they will do it. Let's go down and confuse their language. Oneness. I'm not going to raise one prayer point and say, let's pray for Corona, and then somebody say, oh no, let's pray for Trump. We'll pray for Trump. That's not the issue. The issue is, there's no confusion, there's order here. Are you with me? If you enter a prayer room or a prayer service and you hear the people pray, the pastor preaching, you don't come and tell him to change it to do this. No, sir. No, ma'am. Are you with me? So we're going to be focused. I will raise a prayer point. Together with one voice, we'll pound the heavens. When we finish, we'll go to the next prayer target. Together, we'll pound the heavens. At the last 30, 40 minutes of the prayer session every day, we're going to pray for ourselves. So save your personal prayer request for the end. If you can't wait, then God bless you. I don't know what else to tell you. Are you ready? You're going to open your mouth with holy righteous anger. You must be vexed and angry in your spirit. That this thing called Corona or COVID, whatever name is called, or China virus, as Trump put it, I like that better. Because they used to call AIDS the Africa virus, isn't it? They affiliated Africans with AIDS, only to find out these 30 years later that AIDS and Ebola was patented and manufactured in America. Yes, oh. So please explain to me how it wind up in Africa killing millions. Somebody got some explaining to do. AIDS was known as the face of Africa, or Africa was known as the face of AIDS for almost 30 years. 30 years later, it was patented right here. By the same evil, wicked, diabolical Bill Gates and agenda and the pharmaceutical big pharma on them. And they used the Africans as a medical guinea pig. They're going to pay. They're not getting away with that. The wickedness they have done to Africa, to humanity, they will pay. Payback time is upon them. They're going down. That's where the judgment is coming. It's called sowing and reaping. It's not even judgment. Anyway, let's go back to praying. So those responsible for this Corona hoax and this pandemic, you're going to pray, number one, let God pull back the veil, bring them all out of hiding, expose them. Number two, they must be found guilty. They must be tried in the court of law. A crime against humanity, and they must be found guilty. They must pay. Open your mouth and pray. Pray violently in warfare in tongues. Enough is enough. I want this Corona thing exposed. Everyone behind the hoax, the pandemic, pushing the agenda, I want God to expose every one of them behind it, from the highest office to the least. Expose everyone who started it, who cooked it up, who manufactured it, who push it in it, who unleash it upon society, and who's continue and insist to continue to push it. All their weapons and their resources, begin to expose them with God. Expose everyone behind this Corona pandemic, this Corona hoax. Expose them. Number two, they must all be tried in court with a crime against humanity. Number three, they must be made to pay. And last but not least, we want Corona out of this nation, out of Africa. Open your mouth and let's pray. Everybody, pray in the Holy Ghost, violently in tongues, right now in Jesus' name. Kesari batora makata yera bako hoto yope seti libikiti la kasante rababuro koho sori. Le makora mabataya kisi tibi akoho sende rebebo yokoho sote. La riba kataya ye sati la mambo tari onarabe ke hasari. La riba boto ke seti libi kiti la kaha. Oraberi akara ya kataya ye sandi la mambo torebo koho sori. Esteteyeri, orababe rakahasati, la riba koho sondo robo yoko hosori, limamora kataya kisati, la kahasate, la reba koho, esteteyeri, liba koho sate, la reba koho sati, la bakahasate. All of those responsible and behind cooking up, manufacturing, patenting, and unleashing this pandemic hoax on humanity, Father, expose them, bring all of them to light, and then they must be found in the court of law. They must be charged, try them in the court of the war crime court. That's where they should go. And they should be found guilty of a crime against humanity and make them pay. Borakanda yariba boraka hasate lekana ya city bi akata ya ke lari bi kisatera bako boraba boro kohosote om norbo yokohosori riba boraka hasate rebebe kete yekitili akahasare oraba bera baka hasate rebebe ribe boro kohosoto eriba boraka ha lare bako hosom norbo yokohosori Liba koho sote rebeke heseri li mambora kahasate rebebe yokoho soto le liba bora kahasate rab pray in the spirit lokasari bitini la mambora kaha osonde rebebe yekete yekisari osondo rebo yokoho sete yere libi kitili ya kahasari. Father, in the name of Jesus, unleash your judgment and your wrath over this nation for those who are responsible for cooking up, manufacturing this corona hoax and pandemic and shutting down the economies of nation. It is time for you to judge them, oh God. Expose them. They must be tried in the war crime court. They must be found guilty of a crime against humanity. They must pay. Open your mouth and pray. Om norbo yoko hosete yere libi kitili ya kahasare la reba koto yeseti ya ribabora baba ya kaha orabi kisari ya baboto kohoseri esete yere libi kitili ya kaha orabera kahasate rababo hoso om norbo yoko hosete yere libi kitili ya kaha la reba kohosete le babora kahasari la kitili ya koho mosende ribebete yere kohosoti la reba koho sori era babora kahasate la riba koho soto le bikese riba baraya kahasare Mosondo boye kobo sote e sariba bora kahasare la kiti ariba koto yoko hosete e riba bora kahasare ba koto nyeri ekeheseri. Pray violently in tongues. We have had enough. We have been too nice. We have been too quiet. It is judgment time in the earth, in this nation. Those responsible for cooking up and manufacturing and patenting and unleashing this corona hoax and pandemic to destroy human life, it's time for God to expose them, bring them to light. All of them, everyone and anyone that has been used and is being used to push this corona hoax and keep it alive, expose them. Number two, they must all be tried in the war crime court, charged with a crime against humanity, and they must be made to pay financially and pay with everything they got, that they will lose it all, as they have caused many people across the world to lose it all. People have lost their jobs, their businesses, their careers, their education. People have lost lives. They have to repay. They're not going to get it. They will pay. That is, in the second wave, they're plotting, they will be disappointed because they won't even be around to see the second wave manifest. Some of them will not even be around. I repeat, some of them will not even be around to see the second wave come through. They will be disappointed. Some will be locked up behind bars. If at all, they even make it alive. Pray, my friend, God must judge them. It's called sowing and reaping, Lord. Let them reap it. Grant them the privilege to reap it. What they have done to humanity, they must pay. Haribako sande rabako ho rabaka hasari. Laribako te yese de ye ribabo roko ho sote. Laribako raka hasate. Laribako ho sondo robo yoko ho sete. E ribabo rakata ya kesa ribako tonne ye kisari. O sonne ribabo rakaha. E rababo rakaha sati. Laribako to yoro kisiti libi eke he. E ndaro baba ya kahasare. O sonne ribabo rakaha. O sorebebe yeke. Pray in the spirit. this corona hoax and pandemic, we want to expose. We want to know everyone behind it, responsible for it, pushing it, spreading it. We want to know. We want to know who they are. Bring them to light. Expose them. And then they must all be tried in the war crime court. With a crime against humanity, they must be made to pay. Nobody getting away with it anymore. No more getting away with it. They have to pay, my friend. They're going to pay. Rabara ki sari abako sete. Robo konde ye ki sari. Hale baka ha sari. Oso ribebete ye ki tari bako raka ha sande ribaboro koho. I say it is payback time. We can't be quiet no more. They have shut down the economies of nations. It's time for heaven to shut down their own economy by taking the wealth from them and giving it back to us because they stole it anyway, isn't it? They stole it. How? I know they stole it. How you have 10% of the world's population control 90% of the world's wealth. Then the remaining 90% of us have to fight and scramble each other for the 10%. Is that fair? They stole it. It's payback time. Did you hear over the weekend? Bill Gates' father died at 95 years old. He's one of the co-founder of the eugenics Planned Parenthood organization. You know what that means? He's got blood on his hands, dripping. Let's just pray that hopefully, maybe he repented before he died. If he didn't, you know what he is. Anyway, are you with me? Mm-hmm. How somebody can do such wickedness and even live to 95 years? Because God is merciful. And those 95 years, God was giving him time to repent every day, every day. Who knows if he did? Just like he said to Jezebel, I've given you time to repent. You refuse. You got to go. All the Bill Gates and the Dr. Fauci, the pharmaceutical, the big pharma, all those people responsible for this corona hoax and pandemics, God has given you more than enough time to repent. You refuse. It's time for you to go. Open your mouth and pray. It is payback time. It is war time in the earth. Hello. Pray in the Holy Ghost, my friend. Pray in tongues. Herabakuraka hasari. Osendere riba kahasate murababa riba kohoso to yori leba kahasari babo sondere boyo kohosori leba kota yaki sate raba kohoso te liba bora kahasate raba boho sondere boyo kohosori liba bora kahasate raba boho sondere boyo kohosori e rababi kiti riba bora kahasande raba boro koho. Osete ye riba bora kahasati. La rika sonda riba bora kahasare. Osori de beke se riba bora kaha. Osondo robo yo kohoseri. E rababaya kahasate rababoto kohosori. Riba bora kahaseta riba kote yere ki siti. La reba kotamaya siti libia kaha. Osote rebebeti liya kaha. La kenda rabakoto ye ki se. Those principalities manifest in the flesh as Bill Gates and Dr. Fauci and the big pharma. It is time for them to be exposed and brought down. Open your mouth and pray in your spirit. It's time to wage war. They have waged war on us. They have waged their war on us. It's called corona. Now it's time for us to wage our own war back on them. Flip the script back on the enemy. Open your mouth and pray. Eri babora kahasa tera baboro kohostori. Eri babaya kahasa tera libi kisari. O sonde veye kehesteri. O rababera kahasa ti. La riba kote ye se te ye ri. Ondorbo yo kohostote. Ribabora kahasa te. La riba koho. O sondorbo yo kohosteri. E se ribabora kahasa te. Ribabora kaha. O sondorbo yo kohostori. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. I'm going to raise another prayer point. We are still waging war. I'm going to raise another prayer point. The next prayer point we're going to pray, we want this corona out. We want it out of America, we want it out of Africa. Wherever you're connecting, pray that same prayer. That God, we have had enough. We want this thing shut down. We want it removed from in our culture, in our lifestyle. I don't want to hear his name anymore as long as I live in this nation, on this earth. I want it wiped out. Just how it came overnight and just took over the whole world. That we have even coined new phrases. We have new vocabulary. Social distancing, contact tracing, and all kinds of foolishness. We want this corona out. We have lived with you for too long. We have dealt with you for too long. We have put up with you for too long. Your time is up. You got to go. Open your mouth and say, Father, we are asking you in Jesus' name to unleash and release your angels all over this nation. Pray where you are. Pray for where you are. We want Corona out of America now. We want Corona out of Africa now. Anybody who also Africans, like you're from Africa, but you're living somewhere else in the world, pray for that nation where you were living and then pray for Africa. Are you with me? I'm from Africa. I live in America. So that's why I always pray for those two continents. Yes. At least I should say North America. Open your mouth and pray. Corona. We want Corona out of America. And even other you also who live in America, but you're not African, pray for Africa just like I pray for America. You hear me? Thank you very much. Open your mouth, Father, in Jesus' name. We want Corona out of America, out of Africa now. Pray like that. We have had enough. We have put up with enough. We have changed. We have altered. How dare you? How dare me? How dare they? That we have altered our lives behind Corona. No more. Corona must be the one to alter his life around us. That means it's got to go. We have literally bowed to Corona, isn't it? We have accepted, churches have shut down their doors. We have accepted everything. We have bowed down to Corona, literally. No more. It is time for Corona to bow and get out. Open your mouth and pray. Enough is enough. Father, in Jesus' name, we want Corona out of America, out of Africa now. All you Americans who are watching, you praying with me, pray for that same prayer for America as you're praying for Africa. As I'm praying for America, I'm praying for Africa. That's the continent I was privileged to be born in. And America is the nation I'm privileged to be raised in. Are you with me? So they're both dear in my heart. Open your mouth and pray. And the rest of you, pray for the nation where you're connecting from. And if you're not born from that nation, pray for your nation where you came from. Hey, are you with me? Open your mouth. Open your mouth and pray. Father, enough is enough. We have had enough. We are shutting down the door on Corona. We are serving Corona with an eviction notice. Leave America today. Leave Africa out in the name of Jesus. We will not put up with this anymore. We're not going to shut up anymore. And we're not going to go along to get along. We're not going to change and alter our lifestyle anymore to entertain or to condone Corona's nonsense. We're not going to bow to it anymore. It's going to bow to us and get out. Pray like that. Pray violently in tongues in Jesus' name. We don't want this. We have had enough. We have lived with this Corona, whether it's a hoax, whether it's real. I don't care anymore. I want it out of my vocabulary. I want it out of my nation. I want it out of the continent of Africa. I want Corona to bow and get off. Pray like that. Hey, Rabakasaka. It will become something of the past. Never again mentioned. Even including the second wave that he raises head up. That means even the second wave, this is the first wave Corona. Even the second wave they are plotting, it will not show its face. I say even the second wave they are planning, it will not even rise up. I say it will not even take off ground, it will stay there and die. Open your mouth and pray. They will not have the privilege, the resources, or the time and the honor to even cook up a second wave and unleash it. And God will arrest them and deal with them. And this first wave called Corona, we are chasing it out of America. We are chasing it out of Africa. That even a second wave will not have a chance to raise its ugly head. Open your mouth. Pray for America, pray for Africa, and pray for the nation where you're connecting from. We have had enough, and we're saying, Corona, your time is up. Get out. Pray, my friend. It's time for some violent warfare. Open your mouth, Facebook. Open your mouth, YouTube. Share this and invite everyone, and let's pray. Come on, man. Enough is enough. Aren't you tired? But they lock you up in your house. It's literally called house arrest. They lock you up in your house for 6 months. It's called house arrest, and you're taking it. No more, I'm not taking it. I want to live my life, do my ministry, and do my businesses freely. No matter what's dictated to me, I must wear gloves. I should wash my hands 5 times a day. I should social distance. It's not happening. Not anymore. Not on my watch. Get out. Whoever insists, you got to go. Now, wherever you're going. Whoever insists that we must live by these laws, you're going to follow Corona, wherever God taking it. Ori bako sate raka hasari la keta yaka hasati bikiti. We're not accepting any vaccine either. You're playing for your second wave and your vaccine, whatever. We're not taking it. People ask, will open and they will fight back and push back and say no. Raisa reba boraka hasati. Ori peke he seri baka hari. Ondo rebo yoku hose de ye riba boraka hasati. Oh, son, Boyoko, Boyoko, Jose, Riba, Bora, Bakaha, La ribikitiri akahasate rababo boso to robobo te yereli. Libabora kahasate rababo sote. Roboko sete rebebe tili akaha. Otele rababora kahasate rababo soto. Onerbo yoko bosote yereli bibikiti liyakoho rabakahasare. Osondorbo yoko toboko hoseri. Libabo rakahasa te rabako ho osete ire libi kitili akaha osotore rebe ribabo rakaha osondor boyokoto boyoko ho seri esa ribabo tabe rabakaha sari osotore rebe boyo ribebe ke hesete yeri a ribabo rakahasa te la kiti a ribabo take rababo toko ho sori le kanda ya kiti libi akaha. Pray in the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. We want this thing corona, called corona, out. Open your mouth and pray. We want it out. I want it out of Africa. I want it out of America now. If you are African, you live in a different nation, pray for that nation and pray for Africa. If you're an American, you're not from Africa, pray for America, pray for Africa. Are you with me? We want corona out of America, out of Africa now. And those responsible for the damages and the casualties because of this corona, they must be made to pay. They're going to be exposed, charged with a crime against humanity and made to pay. The billions that Bill Gates thinks he have made, the pharmaceutical industry, the billions they have made, they will give it back. It will be put back into the economies of the world that they have destroyed. Open your mouth and pray. That the second wave, the plotting, is not going to take. It's not going to come up. No, in Jesus' name, it's not. It will die right there on contact, on the spot. You're not going to take. It's not going to take foot and rise. No, sir, no, man. Not on my watch, not on my shift. What about yours? You better be vexed and pray, my friend. Pray in the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. We send the corona back where it came from. The people responsible, it will follow them. Kesari ababoro koho sete ye ribabora kaha. La kiti la kaha sate. Masonde rebebeti ya kahara kaha sanderi ya baboro koho. Ondo yo koho sori. La rebaboro bobo yo sete ye kiti ya kaha sare. La riba koho sondoro bo yo koho sori. E sa riba bo tabaya kaha. O sondoro bobo yo koto yo ribebe ke he seri. Libabora kahasate rababora kahasari la ribabo toko ho sondor boyoko toyo kiseri o sondor boyoko ho seti la ribako ho sate la ribako ho sondor boyoko toboko ho seri e sa ribabo taya kahasare la ribako ho sote ribabora kahasate la ribi kiti libia kaha o sondor boyoko toboyoko ho sete ile libi kiti libia kahasare la reba koho sondre bo yokoho sori riba bora kaha sate raba boto yokoho sori libebe yeke he sete yere libi kitili ya kaha sare o sondre bo yokoto bo yokoho sete yere libi kitili ya kaha sare o sotore bo yokoho sere libebe yeke he seri o sotore bo yokoho sote yere libe ke he seri Orabiki ya hasatera babura kahasari la reba koho sondero yokotobo yokoho seri liba koho sareba bota ya kahasari la riba koho sondero yokoho seri. Hey Father, we have had enough. We have lived with this corona for too long. We have put up with it for too long. We have altered and changed our livelihood, how we live, how we do ministry, how we go to school, how we worship you. We have bent over backward and altered our entire life for this corona hoax pandemic. We're not doing this anymore. It is time for corona to bow. I say it is time for corona and his agents and his messenger. That means those who cook it up and unleash it upon humanity. It is time for both corona and its messengers to bow and get out of America. Bow! Get out of Africa. We've had enough and we're not taking this anymore. Get out. I've had enough. I'm not going to alter my life anymore. I have had enough. Enough is enough. You gotta go. Let God clean house. Get it out of this nation. Get it out of Africa. Pray for your nation wherever you are. It must go now. We had enough. It must bow in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 The next prayer point I'm going to pray. What time is it? Okay, we still got time. The next prayer point I'm going to pray. We're going to pray for the enemies of humanity. I call them principalities manifest in the flesh. I will give you an example. They call themselves CDC, FDA, the UN, the Big Pharma, the Bill Gates, the Pelosi, the KKK, the Antifa, the Black Lives Matter, the Nancy Pelosi, and the list goes on. The Obama, the Clinton, the Hollywood, the Nollywood, the pedophilia, the sex trafficking, the Oprah Winfrey, and the list goes on. The George Soros, you know who they are. The social media bigwigs, the Zuckerbergs, the Facebook, the Google, the YouTube, the Twitter, they censor everything that they don't like. They want to muzzle truth. They want to censor and muzzle truth. Isn't it? The enemy wants to muzzle you. That's why he wear that mask. So you don't speak. And he wants to censor truth. All of them, they are the principality. Can you think for a moment, right? How come Walmart didn't shut down or lose business? How come Amazon and Jeff Bezos, those guys didn't lose? They made more billions. If you go do your research, their net worth increased double and triple. While other small businesses shut down, you lost your job, but their big empire continued to grow and increase. Is that fair? The people responsible for unleashing this hoax and pandemic, they benefited the most. And then we must suffer, and then we must sit down, be quiet, and take it. I'm not taking it, my friend. They're going to take it. They're going to bend over backward, and they're going to take it, if you know what I mean. I say it's time for them to bend over backward and take it, and they're going to take it, whether they like it or not. So you're going to open your mouth, you're going to pray. The enemies of America, the enemies of Africa, you praying just like that. Listen to me. Don't pray another prayer point. We have gathered together with one voice. The book of Acts said they gathered together with one voice. We're like mind, we're like passion, with one spirit, oneness. There's no confusion. The enemies of America, the enemies of Africa, the enemies of humanity, the enemies of the church. You're going to open your mouth and say, Father, we are inviting you. According to Psalm 35, contend. David said, contend with those who contend with me. We're going to ask the Lord. Contend with those who are contending with heaven's agenda for America, with heaven's agenda for Africa, with heaven's agenda for the church. Pray in the Holy Ghost, say, God, we are inviting the men of war to begin to wage war against the principalities that are contending with America, that are contending with Africa, and contending with the church. Those who have made up their mind, if they cannot control the world because the elite, and I quote, they said in their secret meeting when they came out, and I quote, if they can no longer control the world, they will destroy it. That should make you angry. That should make you vexed in your spirit. It's called righteous indignation, righteous anger. Open your mouth and let's go to war. Pray violently in tongues right now that the enemies of America, the enemies of Africa, the enemies of the church, I mean all over the world, the body of Christ globally, we are inviting God to contend with them. Oh God, take them out. Begin to contend and wage war against the enemies of America, the enemies of Trump, the enemies of the church, the enemies of the continent of Africa. Oh God, we are inviting you. You are called the man of war, the Lord strong and mighty, the Lord invisible in battle. May you begin to wage war against the principalities that wants to bring this nation down, Lord. Bring them down. Open your mouth, Facebook, YouTube. Pray violently in tongues. We have come to wage war on hell. We're not taking this anymore. They're going to bend over backwards and take it. Amen. Open your mouth and pray. Pray in the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. Everybody, open your mouth and pray. Come on, Facebook. Come on, YouTube. Hey Rababora Kaha Sateri Babora Kaha. Laki Sande Rababoro Koho Sori. Facebook, are you praying? YouTube, are you praying? Pray, my friend. Enough is enough. Ora baraka hasari bakote yesete yeriba koho rabaka ha onda riba boraka hasate ramaboro boboyo koho sori limaboraka hasate laribi kitili ya koho sare baboto kosonderbe yekehe seri ondorbo yokoho sote yeri hariba boraka hasate lareba koto yositi ya riba kota eramakani la kosonderbo yokoho. We are inviting you, Lord, to contend with those who contend with America, contend with those who contend with Africa, contend and fight against and wage war against those who are waging war, who are plotting to destroy America, to destroy Africa, and to destroy the church. Destroy both them and their agendas. Bring it down. Open your mouth. Pray. In the name of Jesus. Horabakorakahasari. Riba kaserama bonde ye kiti riba kahasare. La riba kosande reba moro koho sondo reba koho sori. Oh, reba baya kahasati. May you rise up from your throne, oh God, in Jesus' name. And begin to stretch out your sword of judgment over the earth. And those who refuse to bow their head to you, Lord, let those heads roll. Pray like that. He raba kosate raba bora kaha. Ena babora kahasa riba kotone yeke heseri. Ela ribi kitira kahasa tera babone yeke teyeki. Ari babora kahasa tera baboro koho. Ondorobo yoko hosori. Pray in the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. He raba konda ria kahasa te. La riba boro koho se te yeri. O raba kahasa ri. The enemies of Africa, the enemies of America, the enemies of the church, oh God, wage war. Fight and contend with them, oh God. They have made it a man to destroy the world. Let God destroy their agenda. They have made it a man to destroy America. May God destroy both them and their agendas. Are you praying, Facebook? Are you praying, YouTube? Pray in tongues right now. We have come to wage war. There's no time to be nice. Go along to get along. It's over. Those people on the other side, they don't understand nice. They understand violent warfare. The Bible said, from the day of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence. Only the violence take it by force. It is time for us to utilize our violence and forceful faith during warfare. Open your mouth and pray. Everybody, pray. Facebook, YouTube. Facebook, are you praying? Yes, amen. You too, are you praying? Is this working on you too? Talk to me, somebody. Pray, my friend. Be vexed. Enough. Not on my watch, not on my ship. America is not going down. But those who made it a mind to bring America down, they are going down. Africa is not going down. Africa will rise up and become a powerhouse because the Bible said, in the end, the last will be the first and the first will be the last. We have always been known as the last. Africa coming back. Africa will come back on the top and she will be on the top. Are you with me? Those who said they were going to continue to keep Africa down and backwards and in darkness, they will be the one who will be down in backwardsness and darkness. Pray, my friend. Their agenda to destroy Africa, their agenda to destroy America, it will be used against them. Their very own weapon, heaven, will turn it on their heads and use it to destroy them. They will be the one who will be backwards in darkness for generations to come. Up to the last generation, they will live in abject poverty that they have caused upon Africa and humanity. Open your mouth and pray and say, God of justice, show up. Show up and defend your name in America. God of justice, show up and defend your name in Africa. Oh, God of justice, show up and defend your name in Africa. Defend your name in America and defend your name in your people called the church. Pray, my friend, pray. Hey, Rabaka Hasari Babo Toye Kesiri. Orobo Kotoyo Riba Baria Kahasate. La Keta Yariba Kataya Kesari. O sondorobo yokoto boko hoseri. La riba bora kahasate. La reba koho sondorobo yoko hosori. E sete ye riba bora kaha. La reba koto yositi ya riba boro boko hoseri. E riba bora kahasate. La reba koho soto boko hosori. Riba kora kahasate. La re. We want the God of justice to begin to stretch out his sword of justice, divine justice upon the earth. Humanity, the cry, he said to Moses, I have heard the cry of my people, so I'm sending you, Moses, as a deliverer. God have heard the cry and the groaning of the souls of humanity, so he's sending us to cry and say, God, enough is enough. Humanity have suffered under the weight and the pain of these people, evil, diabolical, one world agenda and one world order. We have suffered enough. They control 90%, they consume and control 90% of the world's wealth. They decide what you learn in school, isn't it? The education system, they control it. The entertainment, they control what you should find entertaining. They push their agenda in education, in the finance, the pharmaceutical industry, the TV, the media, the social media, they control everything. What thus says the Lord. Give up your control or give up the ghost. Pray, my friend. I say give up your control or give up the ghost. Hare babura kahasari. Ose tende yeriba kataya kosundo bokote yekiti liya kahara kahasari. Otore de kene yekiti li karaka hasari. Orabakana yisiti ababoro koho sondorobo yokoho sori. Eri babora kahasari. La reba koho sondorobo yokoho sori. Eri babora kahasate rababo to yori. Li babora kahasate baboro koho. Ori bebe yekehesete yede li bikiti li akaha. Masenda rababo to koho sori. Libebe kehese ribabora kaha la reba boto koho sondor bo yokoto yo kehese ri libabora kaha satera babo ho soto yori o sondor bo yokoho sori o robo bote ye ki sariba bota kehe sariba bora kaha o sariba boto koho sori bebe kehese nebe yokoho sori O sariba bota ya kahasare la reba koho sondo boko te ye kitili biya kaha are katiri ya babora bakahasare ondo rebo yo koho so pray in the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus that the God of justice will stretch out his justice over the earth and everyone who has been unfairly treated from inception all the families of the earth that has been unjustly and unfairly treated by these devils these principalities God will give them justice. What is in finance? AIDS and Ebola was patented, manufactured in America. Explain to me how it wound up in Africa killing millions. Somebody's behind it. It is payback time and it is justice for those Africans that suffer all these years with AIDS and Ebola. God will give them justice. They will reap. Those devils who did that, they will reap it. That's wicked. That's a whole nother level. These people, the way they are so wicked, they make Hitler look like a saint. If you compare, Hitler was after the Jewish people. These people, they're after the population of the earth, isn't it? Isn't that more wicked? God will judge them. They will pay. They're not going to get away with it. No more. Then you come to the social media. They want to censor you. They want to bully you. They want to threaten you. You can't say this. You can't. The only video they allow is the ones that is pushing their agenda. Is this America? What happened to the freedom of speech? Why have we sat down? We say we're Americans. We got freedom and liberty. And this people have. When did this happen? When did this happen and how did this happen? Why did it happen? When did it happen and how did it happen? That we sat down in America and allow our liberty and freedom of speech to be taken away from us right under our eyes. How did this happen? When did this happen? And why did we allow this to happen? Please tell me. How did we allow the communist and Chinese law society to come and sneak somehow in America and silence us? They call it fact checking. What happened? It's time, oh, it's time for all the agenda to be brought down, brought low. Those behind it, they will be the one who will be silenced, censored, bullied, and threatened. They're going to go back in the cave, and this time they ain't coming back out forever for good. It's time for God to silence them, bully them, threaten them, shut up their voices. All you social media giants and owners of these social media companies that are fact-checking, I'm saying to you, you get born again like a soul. A radical Damascus Road experience and encounter. You get radically born again. That you will use this platform to push the gospel. But any of you who refuse, you have to be removed and God will give your company to the likes of us that he trusts. Are you with me? Or he destroyed the whole thing and build up a whole new one. Whatever it is, but you all have to stop your nonsense. Pray, my friend. Seri babora kahasari bako teye fila kahasari. Lo son de bebe ke teye ki tiliya kahasare babo ton de bebe ke heseri. Morabara kahasati la koro. All of those people in Congress that you have bribed. I mean the social media companies. You have bribed all these devils in Congress. That's how come they've able to pass these laws, what they consider fact-checking, and what is considered, what you're supposed to say. They have bribed all these. So all those politicians that have allowed themselves to be bribed, either by big pharma or by the big computer industry, you're going to turn. You're going to repent and turn, or you're going to be taken out of office. That's it. All the politicians that have been bribed, either by big pharma or the big computer high-tech industry, to look the other way and pass laws that would make it legal. That there's a law in America that the vaccine and the pharmaceutical industry cannot be sued if their product causes harm. Is that fair? Think about it. If you're claiming your vaccine and your product is so good, why you need amenity or something? Why do you need a law passed to protect you from lawsuit? You claim your product is good. then what you need a protection, that's unfair. That law will be overturned and canceled in the name of Jesus. And those politicians that allow that to be passed on their watch, on their ship, because they want money, they will be exposed and will be removed. Open your mouth and pray. And those high-tech computer, because so many times you hear Bill Gates, Google, Jeff Bezos, these guys, they are testifying before Congress. They just had one few months ago. They are testifying before Congress. What became of it? Nothing. Because they bribe and pay their way. But this time around, they're not going to bribe and pay their way out. They're going to be backed up against the wall, and they have one or two choices. They're going to stop their wickedness and turn, or they will be removed. Both they and the company, they will lose their company, or they'll be taken out and the company given to somebody else, or the whole thing crushed and God build up a whole new one. But they gotta go now. Wickedness, unrighteousness, corruption, prejudice, any kind of evil and unrighteousness and wickedness in this land, we are asking God to put the axe to the root. All of those responsible, clean house, clean house, clean house, take them out. Remove them, replace them. Take them out, remove them, replace them, or turn their hearts. Either their hearts are turned, but they refuse to get turned, they have to be removed and taken out of office. They have to be unseated and dethroned and removed. Pray like that, my friend. Pray. We have come to wage war on hell. Are you with me? Pray in the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name, everybody. Facebook, YouTube, let's pray. Mareba bora kaha sari. Oso to yoro libe kehe se riba bora kaha. Pray in the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. Pray Facebook, pray YouTube. Osande riba bora kaha sare babo to yoko hosto ri. Liba bora kaha sate raba koho. Ose te ye de libe kitilia kaha. La reba koho sonde rebo yoko to yoko hosto ri. Libabora kahasa te rababoho sonde boyokoho e se ribabora kaha la riba koto ye kehe seti libe kehe se ribabora bakaha o sonde boyokoto boyokoho se ribebe te yene li o sonde boyokoho sori la ribabora kahasa te rabakoho o siti e ribebe te yene li. Ande rababora kaha, o sare baboto yo ribebe kehe seri. I say all the computer tech giants all over the world that think they have such power and voice and influence, and they are untouchable and they are indestructible, they're gonna have to begin to turn. They will turn or they lose their company and lose their power, lose their wealth, lose their voices. They must turn. They must become born again like Saul. We want a radical Damascus Road experience and encounter of all these guys, including the Bill Gates. They either turn from their wicked ways or they must burn. Are you with me? I say they either turn from their wicked ways or they must burn. They either bow those heads, all of those principalities, their ruling elites, the George Soros, the secret society, the church of Satanists, the pedophilia, human sex trafficking, Hollywood, Nollywood, Bollywood, all of them, the news media industry. They must bow their head and acknowledge that God is God. That means they must get born again. But if they refuse to bow their heads, those heads must roll. I say they must bow their head or it's going to roll. They must turn or it's going to burn. They must give up their control that they have over humanity. The control of the wealth of nations. The control of the education system. The control of the news media, TV. The control of the social media. The control, they have control over everything. They must give up the control and the wealth, or they must give up the ghost now. I want to see it. Not tomorrow. Now it must happen. We have suffered enough. It is time for them to know we serve a prayer answering God. That answer by fire with speed, no delay. Open your mouth and pray. Father, make them turn or burn. Make them bow their heads or those heads must rule. They must give up the ghost. They must give up their power and their wealth, their influence that they have over humanity, or they must give up the ghost. That's it. Turn or burn. Bow or your head's going to rule. Give up control or give up the ghost. Pick one. Don't let me pick for you. You won't like the outcome. Open your mouth and let's wage war. Hey, Rabba Kohosate, Rabba Boro Boboyo Kohosori, La reba koho sote ye de libi kitili ya kahasate. La reba koto yo siti ye ribebete ye de libi kitila kahasare. La reba bora kahasate raba kotonde ye kihari. Ande raba bo songdo bo yokoho. I say the enemies of God, the enemies of humanity, the enemies of the bride of Christ all over the globe, may God begin to visit them from the highest office to the least, the Pope, the Vatican. May the Lord begin to visit all those principalities ruling over nations, oh God. Begin to visit them, oh Father, in Jesus' name. That out of that visitation, they must bow their heads. That means they must get born again. Whoever refuses to bow, those heads are going to roll. They must turn from their wicked ways or they must burn. They must give up the control over wealth and resources of nations, or they must give up the ghosts. That's it. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Give up the control, the power, the wealth, the influence, and the affluence they have had over the minds of humanity, over the resources of nations. They must give it up, or they must give up the ghosts. They must turn or burn. They must bow, or those heads are going to roll. That's my prayer. In America, in Africa, North Korea, South Korea, China, Japan, UK, Canada, all over the world, because these guys have their tentacles everywhere. Of course, their focus and their target is America, because, you know, if they can bring America down, they can bring the whole world down. But they're going down. I said their agenda to bring America down, they're going to go down. Whatever plot they are plotting for America and for Americans and for President Trump, they will repay. The trap and the snare they have set for President Trump and for America, they will fall into their own trap. Pray like that, oh, pray like that. I say, Father, in the name of Jesus, the trap and the snares they have set for President Trump and for America, they will fall into their own trap. The snare they have set for him and for this nation will ensnare them. The net they have set for him, it will entangle them. The gossiping and the lies and the character assassination and the media nonsense, they will reap it in the name of Jesus. Whatever pit they have dug for him will be their grave. They and all their messengers will fall into it. Open your mouth and pray. In the name of Jesus. This is not time to be nice. This is war time, in case you don't know that. Hello. You go to the war on the battlefield. Say, let me hug my enemies. Let's be nice. It's not even in the Bible that today Christian, because they are a bunch of wimps, or they don't understand the time and the season we're living in. So they want to say, oh, let's be nice. Let's hug our enemies. Let's hold hands and sing Kumbaya. Let's go along to get along. You don't do that on the battlefield. This day we're on the war. This God is on the war path, and I'm following him. Don't cross our path and get on the wrong side of me, oh God. That's what I got to say. You don't agree it's a war time. You want to sing Kumbaya, go sit down. But don't come and contend with me or contest with us. Open your mouth and pray that those devils, every trap you have set for President Trump from the day he announced his presidency, every trap will entrap you and those who you used to set the trap. Every net you set for him will entangle you. Every pit you have dug for him, you and your messenger will fall into that pit. It will become your grave. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, I said so. Pray with me, Facebook. Pray with me, YouTube. The enemies of Donald Trump, the enemies of America, the enemies of the church, the enemies of Africa, they're going to have an encounter with God. They're going to have a visitation and an encounter. They either turn or they burn. They either bow or those heads are going to roll. They either give up the power and the control over nations and the wealth of nations, or they give up the ghost. The choice is theirs. No more. Those who are coming against us, the church and the supporter of Trump, heaven's coming against you. All the witches releasing curses, they will eat the fruits of their lips. I say every witches out there issuing and releasing curses and chanting and divination over America, over Trump, over the church, you will eat the fruits of your own lips sevenfold. Can you release that declaration back into the air? Every witches chanting, every witches issuing and releasing curses, chanting, divinations, death threats against Trump, against the church, and against his supporter, you will eat the fruits of your own lips sevenfold. You will eat the fruits of your own lips sevenfold. You will eat the fruits, it's in the scripture, those are Bible, it's in the Bible, that a man shall eat the fruits of his own lips. That's not my words. I'm just praying scripture. If you are familiar with the scripture, you won't ask me where is that. You will know where is that. Hello. They will eat the fruits of their own lips. Yes. I gotta pray. So you will eat as you speak, before the words finish driving out of your mouth, it will come on you seven times. No more time to play games. Amen. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. One more prayer for President Trump. Then we're going to go pray for ourselves and we'll wrap it up. We're going to pray that the Lord will continue to cover him. Open your mouth and pray. We're going to pray that the Lord will continue to cover him. Father, in the name of Jesus, may you release legions and legions of angels to encamp around President Donald J. Trump and his family. Protect and shield and guard them from the flaming darts of the evil one. Anybody who finds himself in the White House or in or close proximity to the president, but they have evil intent, they have evil motives, they have evil desires. Number one, God expose their heart. Number two, get them out. And replace them with people who have the right heart for God, for America, and for Trump. Amen. Pray like that. That the Lord will surround President Trump and his family and shield them with angelic forces that will fortify and protect them from the flaming darts. That no more fiasco, no more distraction, no more hindrance. This man will do his job as God sent him to. Whoever wants to continue to cause a distraction and a delay, take them out of the way now. I've had enough. Remove them now. Remove them. Whoever they are, wherever they are. Remove them, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Pray like that. I said, no more fiasco, no more distraction, no more interruption, no more interference, and no more delay. This man must do his job as heaven instructed him to. He must do his job as God put him in place. Whoever wants to cause any more distraction, disruption, interruption, interference, you will be removed now in the name of Jesus. Say those words back and pray. I've had enough now. No more. No more distraction, no more interruption, no more interference. Anyone who wants to cause any more interruption, interference, distraction, or delay that will not allow the president to do his job, you will be silenced and you will be judged and you will be removed. Never again to have a voice in this nation or anywhere on earth, you will be silenced and you'll be removed. You will be silenced by the very hand of God and you will be removed. Whoever you are, no matter how powerful you think you are, your power, your wealth, your influence, your affluence will be stripped away from you, taken away from you, and given to the likes of us. Hello, pray, my friend. No more. I'm done with this. I've had enough. I'm tired. What is this madness? It's that the news media have become a propaganda machine, and their only job is to find something and just destroy this man. They will reap it. They will be destroyed. Their filthy laundry, their filthy sin, their skeleton, all their filth will be brought to life for the whole public to see. They will be exposed. They will be brought down and brought to shame, reproach, and disgrace. They will be all of them, the news from the office, from the highest head to the least. They will all be exposed. Their agenda, their heart, and their own filthy, dirty laundry will be brought to light. For the whole world to see, it will be brought to light in the name of Jesus. There will be no more distraction, disruption, interruption, or interference in this nation again. The president must do his job as God instructed him to. Whoever wants to cause any more distraction, you will be removed. You will be silenced. You will be removed and dealt with by God himself and taken out. Never again to be heard from or seen from again. Yes. Hey, Rababura Kahasari. Oso tene yeri babura kahasate rabakoho sori. Libebe kete yeri babura kahasande ribaburo koho. Oso to yoro libe ke heste ribabura kaha. La reba koto yoro siti ye ribebe te yere liba kahasari. Oroboboyo koto ye siti ya ribabura babaya kahasari. La reba koho sondoro boyo koto yori bebe kete ye kisari. O narababora kahasa te rababo ho soto yori. E da liba bora kaha o rababera kahasare. La reba koho soto rolo libe ke heseri. O sareba bora kahasari. La riba boro koho soto rebebe te ye de libi kitilia kaha. A reba bora kahasa te. Pray in the Holy Ghost. No more distraction. No more disruption, interruption, interference from any devils. I don't care what you call yourself. Whether news media, whatever, any devil that wants to cause disruption, distraction, interruption, interference, delay, or hindrance against our president, they won't let him do his job in peace. You're going to be taken out. You will be exposed. You will be judged. You will be humiliated. You will be brought down to nothing. The very seed you have sown against him, you will reap it 7 times and you're going to go away. Whether it's an individual or a people group, whether it's an individual or an organization, no matter how big and powerful you think you are, there's no organization out there more big and powerful than my God. And he's going to show you that he's God and you're not. He's going to show you that there's a God that sits in the heavens. According to the book of Daniel, there's a God that sits in the heavens. And he rules in the affairs of nations. He rules in the affairs of men. And he's coming down to rule in the affairs of America. Whoever stands in his way will be bulldozed, taken out. I said it. In Jesus' name. That's my prayer. Amen. 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 Now it's time for you to pray for yourselves. It's 9:15. You're going to pray for the next 30 to 40 minutes in tongues. Going to do violent warfare for yourself now. So grab your prayer request wherever it is. Don't send it to me. Don't email me your prayer request. Don't put it in the comment section. I'm not going to read it. Open your own mouth right now and let each man go to war on their own behalf. Let your NEEDS take you to your KNEES. Somebody can put it on the screen for me on Facebook and YouTube. I would appreciate that. Let your knees take you to your knees. Let your NEEDS take you to your KNEES. We've been praying for what? Almost 2-3 hours. The first 2 hours, we pray for everyone else but ourselves. We save the last 40 minutes or 30 minutes to pray for ourselves. It's time now for you to pray for yourself. But if you don't have any needs, then pray for me. Amen. Open your mouth. You, however you want to cry to God, cry out to him on your own behalf. And ask the Lord to fight your own battle. Whatever be the issues and the concern in your own life, open your mouth and invite the men of war to contend and wage war with whoever or whatever. Any forces, principalities, any works of darkness that wants to contend with your destiny, with your breakthrough, let God contend and take them out. Open your mouth and pray. Pray in the Holy Ghost, pray in tongues, pray in understanding. Every man, pray for yourself. I'm going to pray for myself. You better pray for yourself. Are you with me, Facebook? YouTube, is this working? YouTube, I'm disappointed. Today, you allow Facebook to overtake you. We have, at one time, we have 17 people in Facebook praying. Then we see 10 on YouTube. What's going on? Usually, YouTube is the one that has the biggest audience. Today, Facebook beat you by far. Open your mouth and pray for yourself. Don't let that happen again tomorrow. YouTube, don't let that happen again forever. You must always lead the way in Facebook. Thank you very much. It's a healthy competition. Don't worry. Are you ready, Facebook? Open your mouth, pray for yourself violently in tongues for the next 30 to 40 minutes. I got a clock, don't worry, I will let you know. Pray for your own needs. I'm gonna pray for my own stuff. But if you don't have any needs, please pray for me. Thank you very much. Hey, Rababura Kaha Sari Babu Tendi Ribabura Kaha. Father, every trap that the enemy has set for me, let him and his messenger fall into it. Let their trap entrap them. Let their snare ensnare them. Let their net entangle them. In the name of Jesus, whatever pit of destruction, of humiliation, of shame and reproach they have set for me, Lord, let them fall into it. Hera baria kahasare. Om doro kovo yo koho seri. Eri bakaraya kahasate. Lakiti ya kuraba kaha. Pray for yourself, my friend. Pray for myself. So you pray for yourself. However you want, pray for yourself. Everybody, pray for yourself. In the name of Jesus. La reba koho sate raba kaha mareba potria kaha sare o sondorbo yokoho e riba bora kaha sati loko sote yere. Thank you, Sister Susan. Yes, let your knees take you to your knees. That's correct. He raba bora kaha sari o sondorbo yokoho sori e riba bora kaha sande raba boro koho sete ye riba bora kaha sari e raba bora kaha sate. Om nirbo yokoho sote yere liba kahasare. O rababora kahasate rababoho soto yori. E rababora kahasari. La ribaboto yorobobo yeke hesete yere li. La ribabora kahasate. La ribakoto yori se rebebete yere li bititili akaha. Om darababora kahasari. La rebakoho sondo boyo kote yeki. La ribabora kahasate rababoho. O ribekehe. Pray for yourself however you want. However the Spirit of God leads you to pray for your own self right now. Wage war on your own behalf right now. Each man fight for their own self. In the name of Jesus. May you contend with any forces and powers of darkness. Contend with my breakthrough, my blessings. Everything I lay my hands on, Father, let it prosper and grow exponentially. Hey, Rababora Kahasati, La Ribakoteye Seri. I release the angels of breakthrough to begin to be released upon my life and bring forth every favor, blessing, protection, provision, anointing that I need to live a dignified and honorable life. Angels of God, be released and bring it today. In the name of Jesus, every provision my Father has set apart for me to enjoy this day, I will enjoy it sevenfold. Oh, pray for yourself, my friend. Oh, my friend. Mora babaya kahasa te rababoro kohoso te e sari babora bakahasa ri o songo robo yokohoso ri e rababora kahasa te rababoro soto yoroli e ribabora kahasa ti la rebaboro kohoso to yoroli beke he se te ireli la ribabora kaha la kesa te rababoto kohoso ri Libabora kahasate rababoro koho oso toro boyeke heseri libabora kahasate la ribaboro koho sondo roboyo koho sote ireli le babora kahasati la ribaboro koho soto roboyo koho sori libabora kahasate la ribaboro koho sote ireli rababora kahasati la rebaboro soto robobori bebere yekehe esa rebabora kaha La ke sa riba koto, o se te lebe ribi ki tili ya kaha. O son derbo yo koho sori, riba bora kaha sa te, la reba koho soto yoro libe ke he se ri. Ha reba bora ba kaha sa ti, la riba bora koho soto, rebo bori bebe ke he se ri. Liba bora kaha sa re, la reba koho soto derbo yo koho. Ese te ye de li bi ki ti li ya kaha O rababora kaha sa te rababo ho sondo go yo koho sori Father in the name of Jesus E rabakaha sa rebabo ho soto yori E rali babora kaha La ke sa rebabo to koho sori Li bebe ke he se ribabora kaha La ke na ya koho soto Mo sondo ri bebe te ye de li bi ki ti li ya kaha O rabe rababora kaha O sonoro boyo koho sote yere li bebe ke he seri. O sonoro boyo koho sori. Libabora kahasa te rababoho soto yoro li. Libabora kahasa te rababoho sonoro boyo koho sori. Libabora kahasa re. La reba koho soto yoro li be ke he seri. A rebabora kaha. La ri kahasa te rababoho soto yori. O songer boyo koto boyo ile beke hese te ile libi kitili ya kaha O sare babora babaya kaha sare La riba boto koho sori Ibe beke hese te ile libi kitili ya kaha O sare baboto yo koho sori Ese te ile libi kitili ya kaha O rababora kaha sate La reba koho soto yoro libe ke hese ri La riba koho sate rababo O sare babora kaha La kesa riba boton derbo yo koho sori Ese te ile libi kitili ya kaha O rababora kaha sate rababo ho soto yori He na mambora baka hasari La reba boro yo koho soto Yoro libe beke he se te Yere libe be kitili ya koho Raba bora kaha Ora babe pray for yourself Facebook Pray for yourself YouTube O soto yo ribe beke te Yere libe kitili ya kaha O sa reba boho sondo Robo yo koho sori Pray for yourself, Facebook. Pray for yourself. I will sit down here small. Hey, Rababura Kahasa Rebabo Toyo Ribebe Te Yere Libi Kitilia Kaha O Rabebe Rakahasande Rababohu O Ribebe Ribebe Kehese Te Yere Libi Kitilia Kaha O Rababe Rabakahataya Kisari Masondo Rumuyoko Hostori Esta Rebabo Tabila Kahase La Rebako Tarababera Mambo Toyo Libe Keheseri Mande Rabako Hosondo Robo Yokotoyoki, Erababura Kahasate, Rabakaha, O Dali Babura Babe Rabakoho, O Sareba Botaya Kahasari, Lariba Borokoho, O Sonerebeke, Yedeli, Era Libakora Kaha, La Kesa Ribabo. Pray for yourself, my friend, pray for yourself. Let your knees take you to your knees. O Sondrebo Yokotobo Yokoho, so Ribebeke Heseri. La reba bora kahasari, la riba bora koho soto bokoho. Pray on your own behalf. Pray for yourself. Open your mouth and pray. Oh, sorobo yokoto yo ribe bereke he se te ye riba boho rababa. E rakahasari, la reba bora koho soto robo yokoho sori. Liba bora kahasate raba boho soto. Libebe ke he se te ye de li. Liba bora kahasare, la reba bora koho sondro boyokoto boyokoho sori. Liba bora kahasare ba bora koho sori. E ribe be ye ke he se te ye de li. Bikiti liya kaha. O rababe rakahasari. La reba koho soto yo ribebe kete ye kitili akaha La ke sareba bo koho sori E sareba bo ba ya kaha sareba bo yo koho soro Lebebe kete ye ribebo koho sori O sondo rebo yo kotobo yo koho sori Libabora kaha sate raba boho soto yo roli Libabora kaha sare la rema mo sondo yo ribebe te ye ribabora kaha O sariba boro yo koho O sondo rebo yo kotobo yo koho sori O soto yoro libebe kehe seri La reba bora babora kahasari La riba koho soto yoro libe kehe seri La reba bora bakahasate rababoho soto O sote yere libi kitili ya kaha La reba kotaya kesari bakoto yoro kehe seri O soto yoro libe kehe seri La reba koho soto moto yoro libe kehe seri La reba koho o Sande rababora kahasari E sariba bota kahasare La ribabora kahasate rabakahata ya kisiti Le mambo rabako hoso toyoro libeke he seri A ribabora kaha Pray for yourself, pray for yourself, pray for yourself Do warfare on your own behalf I'm praying for myself, pray for yourself However the spirit of God leads you to pray for yourself my friend, pray Oh, soto yoro libe kehe seri babora bakaha La reba boro koho sote lebebe kehe seri Liba bora kaha sare babo yoko ho sondro bo yoko ho sori Liba baya kaha sare La reba koto ye sete yere libi kitili ya kaha La reba boho sondro bo koho seri Oh, soto yoro libebe kehe seri babora ba Herakata ya kisare baboho soto E sariba bora baya kahasare La riba bora koho sondro boyo koho seri Libebe kete yere kiti liya kaha O sariba boto yoro libe kehe seri O soto yoro libebe kehe seri babora bakaha O rabera kahasa te rababoho so O sete yere libebe kehe seri O sondo robo yoko ho so te yere liba kahasare La reba bora kahasari O sono robo yoko ho so to yoro libebe kehe seri O sareba bora babaya kaha O rababela kahasate raba kaha O soto yoro libe kehe seri babo O sareba bora kaha O sondro bo yoko to bo yoko ho se te yere libi kitile ya kaha Hareba bora kahasari O sono robo bo yoko ho so te yere li Leba koho raba kahasari La riba koho soto yoribebe te ye kisari O son Pray in the spirit for your own self. Let your NEDS take you to your KNES. Let your knees take you to your knees. Pray. Pray for yourself. In Jesus' name, pray for yourself. Mosade rababo ho so to yori. E sari babo rabaha sari. La reba ko ho so to yori bebe te ke he se ri. O rabe kaha sari. La reba bo ro ko ho so te yere di biki tili ya kaha. Mare babo to yo se te yere di biki tili ya kaha. O sa te rababo ro ko ho so ndrobo yo ko ho so ri. Le babo ra kaha sa te rababo ho so. Hey, Rebeberi, pray in our spirit in Jesus' name. Come on, everybody, pray. Hey, Rababora Kahasa, Rebaboro, Boboyo Kohostori, Lebabora Kahasa, Rebaboro Kohostoto, Yesende, Rebekete, Libabora Kahasari, La Rebaboro, Sondrebo Yoko Hostori, Hey, Rababora Kahasari. La reba boho so to yo libe be ke he se ri. O so to yo libe be ke he se ri ba bo na ka ha. O sa reba boho so ondo rabo yo ko ho so ri be be ye ke he se ri ba bo ra ba bo ra ka ha sa ri. E ra bo ro ko ho so to ro bo yo ko ho so ri. Le ba yi sa ri ba boho so ondo rabo yo ko ho so ri. La reba bora kahasari, la reba boro kohosto, toro boyo kohostori, era baboro kohosto, ndoro boyo kohostori, la reba kohosta, era baboro so, teria babora kaha, esa reba bota kahasari, la reba boto kohostori, ese te ye libi kitilia kahasare, o sondo robo boyo se te ye riba bora kahasare. Oso teo yoro ribe ke he se riba bora kahasari. Oso ondre boyo koto boyo ribe ke he se ri. La reba bora kahasari babo toyo koho. Yes, I repare in the name of Jesus. Pray through me for your word to be birthed in my life. Era kahasari. No more delay with speed, exponential growth. Era kataya ria baboro koho soti. Ena rababora kaha. Oso te yeri. Ha reba bora kaha sati. La reba koho soto yori. Ese riba bora kaha. La reba bora kaha sari. Era kaha sari. Oso ndorobo yo koho sori. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. Spend the next few minutes just giving him thanks. Giving him thanks and praise because he is good. Open your mouth and give thanks to the Lord for he is good. His goodness and mercy endures forever. Give him thanks on your own behalf for your answers prayer. I'm going to thank him for myself. Open your mouth and give thanks to the Lord. Father, I thank you. I thank you in advance for answers prayers. I thank you for your goodness and your faithfulness upon my life. I thank you, Lord, for expressing your goodness, your mercy, your love, your grace, your patience, and your long-suffering. Lord, I thank you for you are always good to me. You always have my back. You never let me down, and you're always on time. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you for your generosity. Thank you for your long-suffering. Lord, I love you. I thank you. I appreciate you and I honor you. For you are a good God, a merciful God. Great is your faithfulness. Your glory is enchanted in the heavens. Out of the mouth of babes and infants, you have ordained praises. You are good. You are good. You are kind. You are generous. You are merciful. You are gracious. You are long suffering. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. I thank you, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. I thank you, Lord, I thank you for your faithfulness. You are a good father, a loving father, a faithful father, a kind and compassionate and generous, long-suffering, slow to anger. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness, your kindness, and your favor that surrounds me with a shield, like a shield, in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, I thank you, Lord. Amen. 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 Let me read a scripture for you, and I got to go. We'll do Psalm 91 because I have to run. Sorry about that, eh? Psalm 91, Because you dwell in the shelter of the Most High, you will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. You will say of the Lord, He is your refuge and your fortress, the God in whom you trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler snares and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and buckler. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys, or the corona that destroys at midday. 1,000 will fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand. It will not come near you. Only with your eyes will you observe and see the punishment of the wicked. Because you made the Most High your dwelling, even the Lord who is your refuge, no harm will befall you. No disaster will come near your tent or your dwelling. For the Lord will command His angels concerning you to guard and keep you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands. You will not strike your foot against a stone. You will tread upon the lion and the cobra. You will trample the great lion and the serpent. Because you love the Lord, beloved, and because the Lord loves you, He will rescue you. The Lord will protect you because you acknowledge His name. When you call upon Him, He will answer you. He will deliver you. He will be with you in time of trouble. The Lord will deliver and honor you. With long life, He will satisfy you and show you the joy of His salvation. May the Lord fulfill all the promises, protection, and provision in His words over your life, including the prayers you have prayed for yourself this morning. May the Lord answer you. May you have a testimony. Every morning we'll connect. I want everybody to have a testimony in their individual life, and also a testimony for the prayers we have prayed for nations. So you keep your eyes, be watchful, keep your eyes and your ears open. We had a testimony this morning. I'll repeat for those who came in at the end. We prayed for President Trump yesterday morning, Monday. And the prayer we pray, one of the prayers that we pray, was that he would be healed, released, and back into the White House before Friday this week. We prayed that prayer Monday morning. By Monday evening, he was released and back into the White House. That to show you we serve a prayer answering God. We pray in the morning. We had the answer in the evening. You sow the seed of prayer for goodness upon anybody's life, you will reap it before sunset. You pray any kind of evil, demonic, satanic prayer, and people who like to gossip and just pray, they're going to reap it. Are you with me? So all the prayers we have prayed for the enemies of America, Africa, the church, the bride, the nations of humanity, God will begin to give us answer. We'll see. So we can be encouraged. Because if God doesn't answer these prayers, how would these people even know there is a God? How would they fear God? Why should they think they are not God? No, the time is up. Time is up for them. They're about to find out there is a God and they are not Him. And they're going to bow or their head's going to roll. They're going to turn or they're going to burn. They're going to give up the control they have over nations, or they're going to give up the ghost. That's it. I'm your prayer drill sergeant, Dagnet, and I salute you. Thank you for joining us. We are here Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. to about 9:30, 10 a.m. Eastern Standard USA time. We pray for America. We pray for Trump. We pray for Africa. We pray for the church. And we pray for the world. And then at the end, we pray for 30, 40 minutes. We pray for ourselves. So join us. Thank you for sharing. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for inviting. Thank you for tagging. Thank you, Facebook. Thank you, YouTube. You have any questions? Speak now, forever hold your peace. Anybody here for the first time, let me know so Angel can greet you. Come on, Angel. You know you want to greet the people now. Why are you pretending? Angel, okay, it's your job. Anybody new for the first time, you got to speak because Angel likes to greet the newcomers. Facebook, talk to me. YouTube, talk to me. Angel, say something now. No, I didn't pick you up to come and sniff me, Jaddy. Say something to the people. Facebook. YouTube. You see Angel clapping her hands? Good girl. You see? Angel clapping her hands for you guys now. Clap your hands again. Please clap your hands again. Oh, you are doing a good job now. Please, let's do it again. Clap your hands for the people. Please. You shy? No treat for you. If you don't clap your hands, you won't get treat. Facebook. YouTube. Oh, YouTube is not talking to me. What's up? It's YouTube. I don't know all this time. I hope that was working. I didn't see any comments on YouTube. Well, I think that means you were praying. That's good. Unless it wasn't working. Who knows? We're going to find out. Angel, say something now. Are you shy? Are you shy? You know you're not shy. Oh, thank you, Angel. She said you're cute. Say yes, thank you. Don't you see that angelic face? Look at that angelic face. Isn't your name Angel? Are you going to live up to your name? YouTube? I think YouTube is shy. All right. YouTube, you allow Facebook to. Facebook beat you today. Facebook, we had the largest crowd on Facebook. At one time, we had 17, 15, 12, 14. We just had like 8, 9, 10 on YouTube. Usually, YouTube, we have the largest crowd. I don't know what happened to YouTube today. YouTube, don't let this happen again. Don't let Facebook beat you now. Please. You should be leading the way. Hello? Are you guys with me? I say YouTube. Don't let Facebook beat you again. It's not nice. All right. God bless you. Bye-bye. Let me log off. Facebook, thank you.